Michelle Barada, and welcome to another edition of Bella Branch TV. Today, I'm going to show you how to make an interchangeable iPhone case. Super easy, super inexpensive. So let's get started.
All right, I've got the coolest do-it-yourself project today. We're going to be making interchangeable iPhone case covers. And it's super easy. And so the reason I came about this was my kids love changing their iPhone case covers, and they're super expensive. I'm sure you guys all know this. And even my daughter just recently saw this one that she really was dying for, and it was from a designer, and it was like $60. And I'm like, there's just no way. So I came up with this cool idea. It's super easy. Anybody can do it. And what it is you just put in these different cool craft papers after you've cut them out from the template, and then you just interchange them. So you can even do collages in here, whatever. I'm going to make one for my daughter. She's about to start college, and put one that has the logo of the school and everything in here. So what you'll need for this project is you'll need craft papers, like scrapbook papers, and you can get them from your local craft store, anywhere from a quarter to a dollar. It really depends on how elaborate they are, if they have like sparkles or some cool cutouts on them or something. And then you'll need an iPhone case that is just a clear one. They make ones that are all clear. This one is a white bumper, but you can get them on Amazon for like, I just saw them for $1.54, which I think is pretty darn cool. And then the things you'll need are, you'll need scissors, you'll need an X-Acto knife, super sharp, although mine looks a little dull because I use this one when I'm making my jewelry waxes, and a Sharpie, and a pencil. And then you'll see this cool little thing I have right here, this kind of rubber kind of mat. It's a self-healing mat cutting kind of plastic thing. And what it is when you use your X-Acto knife on here, if you go through, it'll self-heal. It's not gonna make any marks or anything, and then that way it protects your table. So let's get started. It's totally easy. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take out the interchangeable cover I already have in here. And so that's what it looks like without a cover. And I'm going to pick, let's see, which paper do I wanna do? I think I'm gonna use this one for right now. And what you're gonna do now is you're gonna take your cover, and you're gonna find on your paper where you want it to go. I like to move it around and see what looks cool. I really like doing it at an angle, so that's kind of my thing. But it may not be your thing. But whatever you want to do. So what you're gonna do is you're going to put it down like this. So the rubber bumper part or whatever is going to be down like this, and then you're going to trace it around. Okay, you just trace all the way around. There we go. And then you're going to go in here and trace this. Now this is going to, when you trace this inside area, the little windows, so that you know the camera window, it's going to be much smaller, but you're going to see what I'm going to do to make this easier. Okay, so then I'm going to take this and put it here. Then what I do is I take my Sharpie, and I go around this, kind of go over the line, okay, all the way around. It's okay to be not perfect. And the reason I do this is because when you are tracing with the pencil is very thin, and it's going on the outside of your case. And so what happens is that there's, a little bit of, it's much further out than the inside. Does that make sense? I don't know if I'm saying that right. But you need to cut on the inside. So, let me trace this one too. When you're tracing this part, the opening for your camera, you're gonna wanna trace on more of the outside, okay? All right, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my scissors and I'm just gonna simply cut it out, okay? And I'm gonna cut on the inside of the Sharpie, okay? All right, and then when you're cutting this, don't worry if it's not perfect, because it really doesn't show up when you stick it inside your case, and you can always adjust it, and you can always do another one if you mess up. I mean, it's a piece of paper that costs a quarter as opposed to one that costs $40. All right, so I'm gonna go like this. Okay, Swirl it around. I think I get some of the black off there. All right, so I got that part. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the Sharpie and I'm gonna go on the outside of the black line, okay? Not the inside, so I'm gonna go all the way around. Mine, I said, is a little dull, so it would have cut easier if it wasn't so dull. Okay, and I found when I was doing all these, I had to adjust this one and cut it out more, cut it out to change it a little after I stuck it in my thing. So I did have to do some adjusting. So now you have your cutout. Super easy. And you're going to stick it in here and hopefully it'll fit the first time. Otherwise, I just adjust it. Oh, cool. All right. I did notice I cut it a little more right here, but it's totally cool. Totally easy. And I think that's it. You'll need, if you need the supply list, just go to bellabranch.com and click on the Bella TV, and we'll show you everything you need. All right. Until next time, I hope you guys love this. Bye.